What's good, everybody? This is JC, and as you already know, this is internal SSD season, and everybody's excited because Sony sent out a firmware update for beta testers so they could use their internal SSD in the PlayStation 5. Now, everybody trying to get some information on which one is compatible with the PlayStation 5, which one is the best one, which one is most affordable, and they're trying to get more information. And as you already know, I'm always on the grind trying to get some information, and I come across hot hardware, and I thank them for this article. And this one is different from the rest that I aired this week. What I see right here is that this tester who have the Samsung 980 Pro, which I wanted to buy, but I didn't get a chance to come around. I bought the Western Digital 850 instead. And they come back here saying the Sony PS5 benchmarked with Samsung 980 Pro PCIe 4 SSD, and the early results are promising. Okay, let's dive into this. And before I dive into this, you can always go ahead and subscribe to my channel. If you like it, leave a like. I really appreciate it. It helps the video out in the YouTube system. Now, anyway, let me go forward into this. Okay, let me read it right here. As you already know, late last week, Sony revealed a long-awaited beta software that allows PlayStation 5 gamers to take advantage of the empty M.2 slot in their console to expand storage with an off-the-shelf PCIe 4.0 SSD. Okay, I want to stress this out real quick. If you're looking for internal SSD to when Sony send out the software update to use, remember this. There are several kinds in the market. They're going to be cheap ones. They're going to be reputable companies that sell theirs. But always remember, if you're going to get an internal, it have to be at least a Gen 4, not Gen 3, a Gen 4. And speed has to be at least 5,500 megabytes read. All right? Just let y'all know that. Okay, let me just go further down. The PlayStation 5 comes standard with a non-replaceable 825 gigabyte SSD, which I think is pathetic, but anyway. But it can quickly fill up with games, making further expansion a necessity as more high-profile games come to market. You already know, you download the games on the PlayStation 5, you download like 3 or 4 games, and it snatch up this memory like that, because these games today is so highly graphic detail, and the more in details and information it puts, the more memory it requires. So that's what it is. Now that more PlayStation users are installing the beta software, and Sony, I signed up for this months ago. Can you please help me out real quick? It's MODP, my own damn pocket. Check me out. Send me the software update. I signed up with you guys for months, and I'm waiting for the software update. Please don't let me down. All right. Enough of me begging. Let me move on. One such user is a Redditor, Dancy Tapirson. Whoever he is, God bless your heart, man. God bless your heart. All right. Who decided to test Samsung's impressive 980 Pro PCIe 4.0 SSD. Aha. The 980 Pro is rated for up to 7,000 megabytes. Just like the Sabrent, and just like the Western Digital 850. And the other ones, I don't remember by name right now. But I'm going to put out a video with those later. Anyway. All right. See? And 7,000 megabytes read and 5,000 megabytes write. Okay. As you can see, this is what it looks like. And these are the prices that it goes for right here. I'm not going to read too much into it. And this whoever this person is right here, he did the test. And as you can see right here, he achieved results as high as 6,072 megabytes per second with a 250 gigabyte 980 Pro SSD. So that means that after a while, when you play some things, a lot of times people criticize the company because let me use this analogy real quick. You go to the car dealer, they say, I got this beautiful car right here. The car can go up to 200 miles per hour, and it's on the clock that says 200 miles per hour. You get excited, you drive it, you floor it, you only can go to 120. You're disappointed because, okay, you advertise to me, you tell me that this car can go 200, and it says right here it can go 200. Why can't I get the 200? Well, I forgot to tell you that in everything there is a limit. So why are you telling me something and you did not tell me there's a limitation? So these are some things that happen sometimes. But I'm glad to see that the Samsung 980 Pro, as this is one of many that's been tested right now. Excuse me, I'm still a little bit under weather. According to results, whoever this tester is, come close to what they advertise. 6072 megabytes per second. That's pretty impressive. That I like. I give Samsung a thumbs up for that one. Good job, Samsung. But this is it doesn't stop there. However, you will be well advised to heed Sony's warning regarding installing a heat sink on your SSD for choice due to high temperature readings, which were confirmed with this yeast user test. You have to get a heat sink. You can't go without it, but it's recommended. All right. I'm not going to pronounce his name because I don't want to mess up his name. I apologize. I'm going to call it John Doe. State that with an ambient temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, at the temperature for the 980 Pro hover between 55 to 59 degrees. However, temperatures while writing, for example, transferring games to the... Temperatures while writing, for example, transferring games to the SSD soar to 74 degrees. Yeah, that thing's heat up quick. So, like I said in my previous video, I always keep a fan, a very small fan, I buy from Amazon near my PS5. So that things always stay cool. 72 degrees while playing Returnal. Okay, blah, blah, blah. I just say, with this modification, all the temperature dropped to around 44 degrees, while read-write temperature settled at 50 degrees, which is a dramatic improvement with the heat sink. So get the heat sink. This is what it looks like, people. Let me just get out of there real quick. All right. Okay, that's right here. Okay, he did some times with some games right here. Okay, let me show you real quick. This is it right here again. Let me show you. Okay, this is the Samsung right here in all its glory, the 980 Pro. So check it out. Okay. As for actual performance, the Samsung 980 Pro was very comparable to the PlayStation 5 internal SSD. And this is the gentleman results for both Returnal and Ratchet & Clank. These are some new big games. All right. You got a time right here of 13.45 seconds. Okay, Returnal. Let's start with Returnal right here with the Samsung 980 Pro. Time to game, that means it's boot up. That means you booted up. You hit start and you click through the options. And you hit start. I think that's what it's here. And then the game start to play. Time to game, 13.37 seconds. That's impressive. That's very impressive. I like that. Ratchet & Clank's PlayStation 5 primary SSD. All right. Wait a minute. Let's scroll back up here real quick. Let me show you something. All right. There we go. You're not much about time anyway. This is with the PlayStation 5 primary SSD. That's the one that's inside the PlayStation 5. The time to game is 13.45 seconds. All right. And with the internal is 13.37 seconds. So that's like 0.8 of a second. That not much of a difference, but it's noticeable. All right. So it's subjective. You don't have to, and you can. It's subjective. All right. Okay, Returnal, blah, blah, we passed through that already. And Ratchet & Clank for the PlayStation 5 on its primary SSD, the one that's inside. Time to menu is 7.51 seconds. Time to game is 1.79 seconds. That's pretty impressive. Okay, and this is with, Samsung 980 Pro. Time to menu, 7.55 seconds. That's 0.4 of a second slower than the one that's inside the PlayStation. So don't know if it's because of the heat and the memory or what it is. And the time to game is 1.86 seconds. So that's 0.7 of a second. As you can see, gamers shouldn't worry too much about any performance fallouts if they go with a third-party SSD to expand storage. So it doesn't make, to me, it's very subjective. It could be that it's fast. It could be that it's not fast. You're breaking even. All right. The only difference is you're spending extra money for more storage. And I think with more testing, the times could improve, because like I said, it's only at 250 gigabytes, all right? And who could tell, maybe heat have something to do with it, but we don't know. But I think it's pretty impressive still. I still think it's worth getting. I think it's worth it, believe you me. Anyway, let me skip further down so I could end this video real quick. All right, as long as it meets Sony's minimum performance requirements, you should be good to go. Since the PlayStation 4 supports SSDs up to 4 terabytes SSD, this is a quick and easy way to bring more storage to your console. Yeah, which I would say. The only problem is that you're going to pay dearly. Yeah, you're going to pay dearly to hit that 4 terabyte upper limit. Yeah. The same brand, as I said earlier, 4 terabyte Rocket 4 Plus, which means Sony performance metrics will set you back $999. I don't get it, because the one I see is going to set me back for $1,050. What's going on here? All right. So that's basically it right there. And what do you think? Let me know in the comment what you think. Do you think it's worth getting the internal SSD for more memory on your PlayStation 5? Or are you just going to go with the old cheap route? The connect the external. All right. So as you can see, the speeds here, it varies. It could vary based on the internal and many, many variations. So let me know in the comments what you think about it. All right. Because in my opinion, I'm still going to get it. This is the boy JC. Thank you guys for tuning in. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.